Good morning. Welcome to Old St. Mary's Church as we gather to celebrate the Eucharist on this, the 33rd Sunday in Ordinary Time. Please take a moment to silence all electronic devices and let us stand and take a moment to greet one another. All of the readings for this Mass can be found on page 1290 in your hymnal. And the music and readings can be found in this week's worship aid. Feel free to follow along on your phone or device if you'd like on the OSM Parish app, or click the Sunday worship aid link on the front page of our parish website, oldstmarys.com. Our gathering song is number 692, Christ Be Our Light, number 692. We will be singing verses 1, 2, and 5. Longing for light, we wait in darkness. Longing for truth, we turn to you. Make us your own, your holy people. Light for the world to see. Christ, be our light. Shine in our hearts, shine through the darkness. Christ, be our light. Shine in your church, gather today. Longing for peace, our world is troubled. Longing for hope, many despair. Your word alone has power to save us. Make us your living voice. Christ, be our light. Shine in our hearts, shine through the darkness. Christ, be our light. Shine in your church, gather today. Many the gifts, many the people, many the hearts that yearn to belong. Let us be servants to one another, making your kingdom come. Christ, be our light. Shine in our hearts, shine through the darkness. Christ, be our light. Shine in your church, gather today.
We come gathered in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace and peace of God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ be with each one of you. Sisters and brothers, as we begin our worship, let us pray for the grace to use wisely the gifts that God has given us.
Lord Jesus, you are the light of the world. Lord, have mercy. Jesus, you came to lead us out of darkness. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you came to show us the way to a full and holy life. Lord, have mercy.
Almighty God, have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to life everlasting.
Amen. Amen.
Glory to God in the highest.
Let us pray. O Lord our God, grant us the constant gladness of being devoted to you, for it is full and lasting happiness to serve with constancy the author of all that is good. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the book of Proverbs. When one finds a worthy wife, her value is beyond pearls. Her husband, entrusting his heart to her, has an unfailing prize. She brings him good and not evil all the days of her life. She obtains wool and flax and works with loving hands. She puts her hands to the distaff and her fingers ply the spindle. She reaches out her hands to the poor and extends her arms to the needy. Charm is deceptive and beauty fleeing. The woman who fears the Lord is to be praised. Give her a reward for her labors and let her works praise her at the city gates. The word of the Lord.
Blessed are those who fear the Lord and walk in his ways. Blessed are those who fear the Lord and walk in his ways. Blessed are those who fear the Lord and walk in his ways. Blessed are those who fear the Lord and walk in his ways. Blessed are those who fear the Lord and walk in his ways. By the labor of your hands you shall eat. You will be blessed and prosper. Blessed are those who fear the Lord and walk in his ways. Blessed are those who fear the Lord and walk in his ways. Your wife, like a fruitful vine in the heart of your house, your children like shoots all the olive around your table. Blessed are those who fear the Lord and walk in his ways. Blessed are those who fear the Lord and walk in his ways. Indeed, shall be blessed the man who fears the Lord. May the Lord bless you from Zion. May you see Jerusalem prosper all the days of your life. Blessed are those who fear the Lord and walk in his ways. Blessed are those who fear the Lord and walk in his ways. May you see your children's children
the Lord and walk in his ways. Blessed are those who fear the Lord and walk in his ways.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Thessalonians. Concerning times and seasons, brothers and sisters, you have no need for anything to be written to you. For you yourselves know very well that the day of the Lord will come like a thief at night. When people are saying peace and security, then sudden disaster comes upon them, like labor pains upon a pregnant woman, and they will not escape. But you, brothers and sisters, you are not in darkness for that day to overtake you like a thief. For all of you are children of the light and children of the day. We are not of the night or the darkness. Therefore, let us not sleep as the rest do, but let us stay alert and sober. The word of the Lord.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Jesus told his disciples this parable. A man going on a journey called in his servants and entrusted his possessions to them. To one he gave 5 talents, to another 2, and to a third, 1, each according to their ability. Then he went away. After a long time, the master of those servants came back and settled accounts with them. The one who had received 5 talents came forward, bringing the additional 5. He said, "Master, you gave me 5 talents. See, I have made 5 more. His master said to him, "Well done, my good and faithful servant. Since you were faithful in small matters, I will give you great responsibilities. Come, share your master's joy." The Gospel of the Lord. It's Thanksgiving week, so how appropriate that we get scriptures that talk about gifts being given and the impact they can make once we understand them. Now, you may be asking the question, well, Father, that wasn't the whole gospel. Well, it's the shortened version of the gospel that is an option for the presider or the preacher. And the reason I chose to do the shorter one is because I figured you could fill in the rest. I figured you knew that he also gave two talents to one and one to the third, and that each according to their ability would use them, and then the rest of the story would tell us, ultimately getting down to that number, the person who got the one who buried it and didn't use it. But the reason I stopped where I did is because that line, "Come share your master's joy," seemed to be the most significant of what this all talks about. I was also trying to think that we all receive gifts from God, and what we do with them depends on our noticing them and our own abilities. And so I was thinking of three shows that tell stories of the great giver, the good giver, and the non-giver. Spoiler alerts are all over the place, but I figure these shows are enough in the public domain, probably not an issue, but just in case, just so you know. The one who received the possessions and the five talents immediately knows what to do and goes off and does it. And a character that knows who to do that is someone named Dolly Levi. Anyone ever heard of Hello, Dolly? So in Hello, Dolly, she's a widow, but also a matchmaker, and that is her talent. And she is exuberant about it and excellent at it. The plot is that she has been hired to find a wife for Mr. Horace Vandegelder, and that she wants to be that wife. Well, that's beside the point, because her talent is to know who fits with whom. And by the end of the show, we have couples happily engaged all over the place. And Dolly has used her talent by putting it out there and interacting with the community. Does that work? Is that a five talents story? Someone full of possibility and awareness of growing their ability with others. The one who receives the two because of their ability could be someone who needs to develop their abilities more. Another title character who develops their talents in the course of the show is Billy Elliot. Now, Billy Elliot is a coal miner's son who discovers that he loves to dance. He is a passionate man, and living in a community where just about everyone works in the mines and has no expectations for escaping from the mines or the town. To find oneself having a unique interest, other than boxing, which most of the other boys his age are already doing, puts him on a difficult road. But he finds his way to dance, of all things, ballet dance, and dances up a storm. And the truth is, the more he dances and the more we see him dance, we see his talent grow and blossom. He auditions and gets into the Royal Ballet School, and his talents help to set free not just himself, but his family and town, as they discover how investment in a talent and skill can not only free the person, but encourage others as well. The two-talent story. Someone who has to work at it a bit more, but eventually succeeds and shines. And the one who receives the one, buries it, doesn't use it, can you guess? Can you guess the character, the show? Scrooge. Scrooge. Ebenezer Scrooge, of course, before Christmas Eve. Now that's important, and that's part of the reason I'm steering this the way I am. Isn't he the classic of someone who's been given a possession and talent, great wealth and ability, and buries it? He does not help anyone. And notice that as the first part of the story goes along, he doesn't really help himself either, but gets meaner and stingier. Who, after all, goes home and feasts on gruel? Isn't it a classic for someone who doesn't value themselves? Had Christmas not come along, the images of the people ransacking his home, disparaging him, forgetting about him, would have all come to pass. Three stories, three folk using the master's possessions that they've been given. We are given the possessions of Christ, the Son of the Father, this communion we celebrate, this action of Mass we celebrate together depends on our understanding of what we've been given and how we respond to it. And it's not just a 5-talent gift or even a 10 or a 10 to the 10th power gift, but it's much greater and beyond. But it is up to us to use what we have been given. This is the great thing about Thanksgiving week. All we've been given is an opportunity to think about. Then we get to do a gut check about what we can do with it, with Jesus and the Spirit's help. The punchline of the Scrooge story, how it differs from the 1-talent servant that would have been described in the gospel, is God sends the spirit of Christmas, showing the complexity of past, present, and future realities of Scrooge and his family and friends, and all of a sudden hearing that at Christmas it might be pleasant to remember who it was that made the lame beggars walk and the blind people see, connects us with the Christ image that gives light to the Christmas image, the light we have heard about in the readings today, and how the giftedness of the good wife and how the giftedness of what we have been given can change and help our world. And when we think of the Christ gifts given us and enter into this Thanksgiving week, this gift of celebration we are part of together blesses all the gifts that we are given and called to use. See your gifts. See our gifts. Because every gift given by Christ is meant to be shared. Live the promise. Give the promise. Come and share the Master's joy.
I now invite those who are preparing to receive the sacraments at Easter time to be baptized or make a profession of faith in their catechists to come forward. We send you forth at this time to reflect more deeply upon the scriptures that we've all shared today. Know that you go with our constant prayers for you. Go now in the peace of God.
Go in peace, the peace of Christ, and learn the ways of God. Go in peace, the peace of Christ, and learn the ways of God.
Let us now renew our profession of faith, this morning using the words of the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to hell. On the third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From there he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. My friends, we come before our kind and merciful God, and we lift our voices in prayer.
May the ministers of the church serve selflessly and faithfully, and may world leaders be unafraid to take the first steps that can lead to lasting peace. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for peace and for a just resolution of the wars in Ukraine, Israel, and Gaza. Comfort and healing to all who have experienced horrific acts of violence and destruction, we pray. Comfort and bring healing to all those whose lives have been affected by continuing acts of violence by guns, we pray. For those who are ill, and for all who care for them, we pray. That those who have died, whom we call to mind during this month of remembrance, especially Merv Sims, will feast forever in the banquet hall of heaven, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let all the prayers of this faith community be united with the prayers of the church throughout the world. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Hear the prayer of your people, O God of light and life. Bring peace to divided hearts and to lands scarred by war and hatred. Make us one in love of your Son, Jesus Christ, who is Lord forever and ever. Amen. Today, a special collection is taken up to support the work of the Catholic Campaign for Human Development. Each year, these funds from the CCHD empower thousands of more poor Americans to claim their economic rights and reclaim their dignity. So we will take up two collections. The first time the baskets are passed, please put your old St. Mary's offering in that. The second time the baskets pass you, your human development, your campaign for human development offering. And we thank you, as always, for your great generosity.
Our presentation of Give Sim is number 907, What You Have Done For Me, number 907.
Seek will find, so seek.
my face in every face and see the eyes of God. What you have done for the least of my children, you have done for me. What you have given with nothing left to give, you have given me. I am the hungry, I am the poor, I am the stranger outside your door. So when you feed the hungry, when you clothe the poor, I will no longer be just a stranger at your door. What you have done for the least of my children, you
pray, sisters and brothers, that our offering may be acceptable to God the Almighty.
May the Lord accept this sacrifice of your hands for the grace of the glory of his name, for our good and the cause of his religion.
Grant, O Lord, that what we offer in the sight of your majesty may obtain for us the grace of being devoted to you and gain us the prize of everlasting happiness through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For out of compassion for the waywardness that is ours, he humbled himself and was born of the Virgin. By the passion of the cross, he freed us from unending death, and by rising from the dead, has given us life eternal. And so with the angels and the saints and the whole company of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory is without end, we acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna in the highest.
Indeed, you are holy, O Lord. You are the source of all holiness. And we ask you to make holy these gifts by sending down your Spirit upon them, so that they may become for us the body and the blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, he broke it. He gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when they had finished supper, Jesus took the cup. Once again, he gave you thanks, and giving it to his disciples, he said, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for all for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." the mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the cup of salvation, giving thanks that you have counted us worthy to be in your presence and to serve you. We pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Lord, remember your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity together with Francis our Pope and Blaise our Bishop. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all those who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your presence. Have mercy on us all, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, with St. Paul and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may be co-heirs with them to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen, 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 amen.
Lifting our voices together, we pray those words Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, from every evil, and grant us peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we might be free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus, you said to your apostles, I leave you peace, my peace I give you. Look then not upon our sins, but upon the faith of your church, and grant us the peace and unity of your kingdom where you live forever and ever. Amen. May the peace of the Lord be with you always. May we share with one another some sign of the peace of Christ. God, who takes away the sins of the world, happy and blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
Our communion hymn is number 1044, Gusten Ibeyan, number 1044.
Gusten Ibeyan, qué bueno es el Señor, qué bueno es el Señor. Taste and see the goodness of the Lord. Vengan los hambrientos, gusten y vean, come all who hunger, taste and see the goodness of the Lord, the goodness of the Lord. Gusten Ibeyan, gusten Ibeyan, que bueno es el Señor, que bueno es el Señor. Taste and see the goodness of the Lord. Vengan los sedientos, gusten y vean, all you who thirst, taste and see the goodness of the Lord, the goodness of the Lord. Gusten y vean, qué bueno es el Señor, qué bueno es el Señor. Taste and see the goodness of the Lord. Vengan los pobres, gusten y vean, come all you poor ones, taste and see the goodness of the Lord, the goodness of the Lord. Gusten y vean, gusten y vean, qué bueno es el Señor, qué bueno es el Señor. Taste and see the goodness of the Lord. Vengan los dolientos, gusten y vean, all who are grieving, taste and see the goodness of the Lord, the goodness of the Lord. Gusten y vean, gusten y vean, qué bueno es el Señor, qué bueno es el Señor. Taste and see the goodness of the Lord. Vengan los que sufren, gusten y vean, come all who suffer, taste and see the goodness of the Lord, the goodness of the Lord. Gusten y vean, gusten y vean, qué bueno es el Señor, qué bueno es el Señor. Taste and see the goodness of the Lord.
Let us pray. We have partaken of the gifts of this sacred mystery, humbly imploring, O Lord, that what your Son commanded us to do in memory of him may bring us growth in charity through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Kind of be seated for a couple of announcements. Thank you for joining us for Mass this morning, both here in person and those who are joining us from a distance. As always, please take a copy of today's bulletin. All the information in the bulletin is also listed on the parish website and on the OSM parish app. A reminder that this is the weekend that we make Chicago Share vouchers available for purchase. These vouchers can be given to people who you encounter who ask for assistance, and they can be used to purchase food at some grocery stores and neighborhood grocery stores and restaurants. So please stop by the table in the Commons after Mass. The annual giving tree, the Christmas giving tree, is set up in the Commons. And again this year, a number of the organizations that we support with the giving tree are requesting gift cards. You're invited to take an ornament from the tree, purchase the gift shown on the back of the ornament, follow the wrapping instructions on the tag, and return the gift with the tag attached no later than Monday, December 11th. You can also make a cash donation to the Giving Tree by going to oldstmarys.com, click on the Give button, and select from the drop-down menu, Giving Tree. This Thursday is Thanksgiving Day. I don't have to remind you of that. And Mass will be celebrated here at 10 a.m., so you're invited to make that a part of your Thanksgiving observance. As is our tradition, the collection that day will go to support the charitable work of the Social Justice and Service Committee. Also in the bulletin, next Saturday, there will be an anointing of the sick offered at the 5 p.m. Mass next Saturday. And on Tuesday, November 28th, there'll be a remembrance prayer in times of darkness. There's more information about both of those in the bulletin today. Finally, do we have any visitors or newcomers with us today? Would you please stand so we could recognize you? Any visitors or newcomers, Old St. Mary's? Thank you for joining us today. Those of you who will be traveling for Thanksgiving, good luck. But have a joyful and pleasant Thanksgiving reunion with family and friends, and we'll keep you in our prayers as you travel. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you with the blessing of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Our Mass has ended. Let us go forth in the peace of God.
Thanks be to God. Our recessional hymn is number 783, We Walk by Faith, number 783.
We walk by faith and not by sight, no gracious words we hear from him who spoke as not a spoke, but we believe him near. We may not touch his hands and side, nor follow where he trod, but in his promise we rejoice and cry, my Lord and God. Help then, O Lord, our unbelief, and may our faith abound to call on you when you are near and see where you are found. That when our life or faith is done in realms of clearer light, we may behold you as you are with full and endless sight. We walk by faith and not by sight, no gracious words we hear
from him who spoke as none spoke, but we believe.